Good morning, students. So today we will discuss about artificial sweetener. As we have discussed in the last lecture about natural sweetener, we have discussed about sugarcane and honey. In this, we will discuss about artificial sweetener. Example, they are aspartame, saccharin, cyclamine. They are further artificial sweetener based on the calories. Some sweetener contain calories, some contain low calories, and some are non-calories. In the calories, we discuss about sucrose, fructose, maltose, etc. In low calorie, we will discuss about aspartame, saccharin, etc. Non-calorie examples are like cyclamate, etc. So, in aspartame, what is aspartame? It is an sweetener formed by the combination of two amino acids. First is aspartic acid and other is phenylalanine. It is white, colorless, odorless product, crystalline powder form found in the market. It is used in soft drinks, chewing gums and many other sweetened products. It enhances fruity color. It is not stable to heat. As we heat it chemically, its formation changes. It is not stable to heat. According to FAO, WHO, aspartame allowed daily intake is about 40 mg per kg body weight. It is 180 to 200 times sweeter than sucrose. Next comes the saccharin. It is sodium orthobenzene sulfoamide, or it is also called as calcium salt. It is 300 times sweeter than sucrose. Aspartame we have read now, it is 182 or 200 times. The saccharin, it is much more sweeter, it is 300 times sweeter. But if you use its large amount, then it causes bitterness. At high concentration, bitterness is caused. So what we do? We add cyclamate, aspartame, etc. along with it in order to avoid the bitterness. So it is, but the positive point is that in any extreme condition, in any processing conditions, we can add saccharin. It's the characteristics, or it is stable. It does not change very easily. There is no chemical change in it. It is chemically stable. According to FAO, WHO, the daily intake is about 0 to 2.5 mg per kg body weight. It is also said by the government that only up to 100 ppm of the saccharin is used under the Food Adulteration Act. Otherwise, it is included in the adulterant. So these things should be remembered. If we have to use these kinds of sweeteners in the product, is the intake as decided by the FAO, WHO, it should be noted. Thank you, students.